Alright. I'll just need to make the most of my circumstances, and I'm sure good fortune will find me. And I guess that starts with writing a poem tonight. Again, I love these background graphics. Oh, I love the cheese! It's time to write a poem. Pick words you think your favorite club member will like. Something good might happen with whoever likes your poem the most. Ooh. Huh. Okay. Well, I do like Yuri the most, for obvious reasons. Let's see. 1 of 20. Okay, so I can only pick one. Try to be too obvious. I like the word crimson. Oh, okay. Melody, precious, peaceful prayer. Ocean. Oh. Romance, bliss, and music. Okay. Not bad. Feather, shame, determination. Eternity. Okay. I'm just picking words that I just like the sound of. Vivacious. After image. The program. After effects. Anime. Heart, passion, lipstick. I just like the word vivacious. Okay. I don't even know what to throw home. I'm stupid. A tone. Unrestrained whisper. Disoriented. I like imagination. Really? I actually thought that would have been her. Extraordinary, unrequited, strawberry. I just want to pick that because I like strawberries. Okay. Candy, marriage, puppy. Puppy! I have to pick puppy. Charm, anger, skipping, giggle. Fireflies, perfect. I was almost a little dyslexic looking at both of those. They look the same. Graveyard, family, dull graveyard. Bouncy, vitality, Valentine, pain. Papa! Intellectual, uncanny, I like nature. Okay. Whistle, mouse, question, loud, fireworks. Poof! Uncontrollable, clouds, pop, shopping, sunny bunny, treasure, socks, sticky, explode. I like treasure. Philosophy, tenacious, entropy, sparkle, jump, lollipop, misfortune, fickle, comfort, vertigo. Well, I like sparkle. Yeah. Forgive, electricity, kiss, kawaii, starscape, raindrops, destiny. Yeah, heart. Here, vanilla. Fester. Adams. Aura, vacation, sunset, nibble, inferno, fun, frightening. Frightening goes with horror. So, excuse me. Twirl, infinite, excitement, incapable, contamination, flying, sugar, shiny, beauty, rainbow. Rainbow. Extreme, massacre, insight, that's an easy one. Cage, effulgent, misery, existence, time, special. Like existence. For some reason. Okay. Pink landscape, holiday. Doki doki, I had to throw that in. Marshmallow, unstable. I like dream or fantasy. I like dream. Covet, judgment, hopeless, wrath, nightgowns, play, stars, chocolate, pleasure. I like this. Anxiety. I have no idea. Like, if this is really for a poem, how are you putting this all together? Anxiety, email, journey, disown, heartbeat, vibrant, friends, breathe, dazzle, incongruent. I like heartbeat more. Okay. Hi again, Genocide. Glad to see you didn't run away on us. Nah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but I at least keep my word. Well, I'm back at the Literature Club. I was the last to come in, so everyone else is already hanging out. Thanks for keeping your promise, Genocide. I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you. Making you dive headfirst into literature when you're not accustomed to it. Maybe my character isn't into it, but I am for sure into this, so I'm gonna make my character get into this. Oh, come on. Like, he deserves any slack. I have to go for Yuri, AJ? Okay. I gotta go dark for Yuri. Well, I'm just gonna play it out and see, like, how this goes for my first poem. I feel like, I'm probably gonna do more of that. Why would you, like, limit that one little thing to one section of the game? because it's so cute. I love the little chibis they drew for that. Sayari told me you didn't even want to join any clubs this year. You bitch! You ratted me out! And last year, too. I don't know if you plan to just come here and hang out or what. But if you don't take us seriously, then you won't see the end of it. Natsuki, you certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps her manga collection in the club room. Natsuki finds herself stuck between saying Monica and manga. Manga is literature! Sort of. It's more like a graphic novel. Kind of a graphic novel. Swiftly defeated, Natsuki pops back into her seat. Don't worry, guys. Genocide always gives it his best as long as he's having fun. He helps me with busy work without me even asking. Like cooking, cleaning my room. How dependable. Sayori, that's because your room is so messy it's distracting. You almost set your house on fire once. Is that so... You two are really good friends, aren't you? I might be a little jealous.
How come? You and Genocide can become good friends too.
Yes. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Sayori?
Hmm?
As usual, Sayori seems oblivious to the weird situation she just put me into. I have friends that do that constantly.
Oh! Yuri even brought you something today, you know?
Wait, Sayori. Me? Not really.
Don't be shy.
It's really nothing. What is it? Never mind.
Aw, the way they draw her face.
Sayori made it sound like a big deal when it's really not. What do I do?
Huh? I'm sorry, Yuri. I wasn't thinking.
I guess that means it's up to me to rescue this situation. Hey, don't worry about it. First of all, I wasn't expecting anything in the first place. So, any nice gesture from you is a pleasant surprise. It'll make me happy no matter what.
Is that so?
Yeah, I won't make a big deal. I won't make it a big deal if you don't want it to be.
Alright. Well, here.
Yuri reaches into her bag and pulls out a book.
I didn't want you to feel left out, so I picked out a book that I thought you might enjoy.
Ooh? It's a short read, so it should keep your attention, even if you don't usually read.
And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted.
This is... How is this girl accidentally being so cute?
Right?
She even picked out a book she thinks I'll like, despite me not reading much.
Yuri, thank you! I'll definitely read this.
I enthusiastically take the book.
Phew. Well, you can read it at your own pace. I look forward to hearing what you think.
Now that everyone's settled in, I expected Monica to kick off some scheduled activities for the club.
I want to know what the book is.
I want to read that book. But that doesn't seem to be the case. Sayori and Monica are having a cheery conversation in the corner. Yuri's face is already buried in a book. I can't help but notice her intense expression, like she was waiting for this chance. Meanwhile, Natsuki is rummaging around in the closet. Okay, we needed a wipe for that? It's the same background, but... Man, it looks like no one wants to be bothered today. I slump down into the nearest desk. How am I supposed to occupy myself with something literature-related by myself like this? I guess I could always read some of the book Yuri gave me. But I'm feeling a little too tired to read. I could probably fall asleep right now. I close my eyes and end up listening in on Sayori's conversation with Monica.
We're probably gonna seem really lame compared to all the other clubs, though.
Well, we can't give up. The festival is our chance to show everyone what literature is all about. The problem is that the idea of a literature club sounds too dense and intellectual. But it's not like that at all, you know. We just need a way of showing that to everyone. Something that speaks to their creative minds.
That doesn't solve the problem, though.
What do you mean?
Even if we come up with the most fun thing ever, nobody will come in the first place if it's a literature event. So it's more important to figure out how to get people to show up in the first place, you know? And after they come, we can do the thing to speak to their creative minds.
What's this? Sayori is taking this really seriously. It's rare to hear her deliberating like this.
That's a good point. In that case, do you think food will do the trick?
What kind?
Well, I guess we could...
Cupcakes!
thinking. Natsuki would love to do that.
You're right! Natsuki makes the best cupcakes. That works out perfectly.
Am I gonna, like, find out sooner or later she's not really making the cupcakes, she's just, like, stopping at a store on the way to school?
That wasn't why you suggested it. Cupcakes speak to my creative tummy.
Oh, you're adorable.
Cupcakes it is, then. I'm hungry.
Anyway, we still need to work out the details of the event itself. I find myself smiling. In the end, Sayori is still her usual self. But therein lies the unexpected reason I admire her. Unlike me, who has trouble finding any motivation at all, Sayori can put her mind to things and make them come to life. I suppose that's why I end up letting her get on my case about things. I can't help but wonder what it would be like to see the world through her eyes. Oh! God! There's a slight blur I can see. I open my eyes to find Sayori's face filling my vision. I nearly fall out of my chair.
Sorry! Wait. Actually, I'm not sorry at all. It's your fault for sleeping like that. This isn't the napping club.
Does your school have a napping club? Does our school have a napping club?
You're staying up late again, aren't you? Now that you're in a club, you're gonna have less time for anime, you know. You'll need to get used to it.
Don't say that out loud. I glance over my shoulder to see if Monika overheard.
It's true, though.
Yeah, I know, I know. You're always looking out for me, Sayori.
It's what I do best.
That's a problem. What about you? You look out for me better than you look out for yourself. You're still oversleeping every day, aren't you?
Not every day.
That's not very convincing. How many days this past week have you gotten up on time?
It's a secret.
Why is that a secret? I knew it.
Come on! At least give me the benefit of the doubt.
I can't even do that. Look, Sayori, it's written all over you.
Huh?
Sayori glances around at herself.
How is it written all over me?
Okay, you're a little bit of an airhead. You were clearly in a rush this morning. Look, your hair is sticking out all around here.
Oh.
I run my fingertips down the side of Sayori's hair, trying to straighten it out. Man, you really need a brush for this.
My hair is just really hard to get right.
I won't fall for that. Like, there's like slight flirting here, so it's like, it's fine, we've been friends for how long? There's more than just your hair. Look, your bow isn't straight either. And there's a toothpaste stain on your collar right here. I try to wipe off the stain with my finger.
But nobody would ever notice that.
Of course they would. Nobody's gonna tell you about it because they don't want to embarrass you. Fortunately, I really don't care about that.
You meanie.
You don't even keep your blazer buttoned up. Seriously, Sayori. Why do you think you don't have a boyfriend yet?
Huh? That's super mean!
Sorry, but you'll thank me later.
Well, that's not to say that, like, every dude is, like, not gonna like her for the same reasons.
Sometimes somebody's just like, hey, you just like being you, that's fine. I start to button her blazer from the bottom. I have to button up her stuff for her? Once you see how much better it looks, you'll change your mind. Okay. I thought she was just wearing socks for a moment. I'm like, this is a great school. You can take your shoes off.
This is so funny.
What is?
Well, I was just thinking how weird it is to have a friend who does these kind of things.
Huh? Don't say that. You'll make me feel weird about it, stupid.
It's okay, though. I'm happy we're like this. Aren't you?
I guess.
Hey, be careful. The button might come off.
Why is this one so hard to close? I struggle to fully close the button near her chest. Does this thing even fit you properly?
It did when I bought it.
If you ever buttoned it, you would have noticed sooner that it doesn't fit you anymore. What are you smiling about?
It means my boobs got bigger again. Oh, girl!
Don't say that out loud!
Anyway. You look much better now, so.
Ah. Why does it feel strange to see Sayori's blazer buttoned up like that?
But it's so stuffy. It's not worth it at all.
Sayori hastily unbuttons her blazer once more. All that work. That's so much better. Sayori puts her arms out and twirls around. So if I keep it unbuttoned, then I won't get a boyfriend, right? What kind of logic is that? And why are you saying that like it's a good thing?
Because if I had a boyfriend, then he wouldn't even let you do things like this. And you take care of me better than anyone else would anyway. So that's why I'm keeping it unbuttoned.
Stop saying all these embarrassing things!
Huh? I didn't say anything embarrassing.
Jeez. Well, anyway, just focus on trying to wake up a little earlier.
Only if you focus on getting to bed earlier.
Fine, fine. It's a deal.
I guess we really are better at taking care of each other than we are taking care of ourselves.
Yeah, I guess so, huh.
So, maybe you should come wake me up in the morning.
You're doing it again, Sayori.
Aw, but I was joking that time.
Man, it's impossible to tell with you sometimes.
Okay, everyone.
Huh? Monica suddenly calls out.
Why don't we share the poems we wrote now?
Oh, we are sharing. Okay.
Yay!
I thought it was just like a side mission thing.
Genocide, I can't wait to read yours.
Yeah, same. I failed to sound enthusiastic, but Sayori still trots away to retrieve her poem.
By the way, did you remember to write her poem last night?
Yeah. My relaxation ends. I can't believe I agreed to do something so embarrassing. I couldn't really find much inspiration since I've never really done this before.
Well, now that everyone's ready, why don't you find someone to share with? I can't wait!
Sayori and Monica enthusiastically pull out their poems. Sayori's is on a wrinkled sheet of loose leaf torn from a spiral notebook. On the other hand, Monica wrote hers in a composition notebook. She's fancy. I can already see Monica's pristine handwriting from where I sit. Natsuki and Yuri reluctantly comply as well, reaching into their bags. I do the same myself. Oh, who should I show my poem to first? I'm gonna just go down the line, let's go to Sayori. I'm definitely most comfortable sharing it with Sayori first. She's my good friend after all.
Hmm? Oh my goodness! This is so good, Genocide!
Huh?
I love it! I had no idea you were such a good writer!
Sayori, you must be seriously overreacting. I'm not a good writer at all. I honestly have no idea what I'm doing.
Well, maybe that's why. Because I have no idea what I like either.
Jeez. I'm sure Yuri's opinion has to be a little more constructive than this. Maybe even Natsuki's. Are you sure you don't like it just because- Are you sure you don't like it just because I wrote it? Eh?
Well, I'm sure that's part of it. I think I understand you better than a lot of other people, you know. So when I read your poem, it's not just a poem. It's a genocide poem!
Oh, that's cute.
And that makes it feel extra special. Like, I can feel your feelings in it.
Sayori hugs the sheet against her chest. You're so weird, Sayori. That is something I wanted to say to her.
I'm really happy just that you wrote one. It just reminds me of how you're really a part of the club now.
Not to mention the fact that I'm standing in front of you in the club room.
well, of course.
I'm not really into it yet, but that doesn't mean I'll break my promise.
See? It's like I said before, Genocide. Deep down, you're not selfish at all, you know?
I didn't think I came off as selfish at first.
Trying new things like this for other people. That's something that only really good people do.
Thanks, Sayori. I'm not sure Sayori sees the full picture of my motive here. Then again, I can't deny that she's part of the reason I joined. Knowing how much this means to her and all.
Yeah, and I'm gonna make sure you have lots of fun here, okay? That will be my way of thanking you.
Alright, I'm going to hold you to that then.
Yay! Now you'll read my poem too, right?
I guess we'll read first?
Don't worry, I'm really bad at this.
We'll see about that. Oh, I do get to read it! Click outside poem area to continue. Okay.
Dear sunshine, the way you glow through my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you missed me. Kissing my forehead to help me out of bed, making me rub the sleepy from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away a rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever. But I'm not mad. I want breakfast.
It was so pretty until the end.
Sayori, this is just a guess, but did you wait until this morning to write this?
No!
Just a little bit. You can't answer just a little bit to a yes or no question.
I forgot to do it last night.
Well, at least that makes me feel a little better about myself.
Don't be mean! I still tried my best. I'm still good.
It was very sweet until we got to the end.
Yeah.
I didn't mean to say that it was a bad poem. It came out nice, or how should I put it?
It sounds just like you.
Really?
Yeah.
Especially that last line.
I made eggs and toast.
Even though you were late to school?
It's bad to skip breakfast.
I do all the time, just because I never have the time.
I get all cranky.
Well, I guess there's no point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me.
This was so much fun. Monica's the best.
Yeah.
But next time, I won't forget. And I'm gonna write the best poem ever.
Well, I guess I look forward to it.
Alright.
Oh, it took her away. Okay. Then I guess I'll go to Natsuki next.
I'm still confused by your hair.
Well, it's about what I expected from someone like you.
That's a little blunt.
Well, excuse me. It's not like I said it was bad.
Well, you kinda... provoked that in me.
It just didn't evoke any emotions.
So basically it's not cute enough for your taste?
Do you want to get smacked?
Try it. I'll pass.
Well, anyway, I guess I need to show you mine. Not that you like it.
Well, this is short.
Eagles can fly. Monkeys can climb. Crickets can leap. Horses can race. Owls can seek. Cheetahs can run. Eagles can fly. People can try. But that's about it.
It's simple, and it just explains what things can do.
Yeah. I told you that you weren't gonna like it.
I like it. But?
Just be honest.
I am.
Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it?
Well, because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff. So people don't even take my writing seriously.
But isn't the point of poems for people to express themselves?
Your writing style wouldn't make your message any less valid.
Yes, exactly! I like when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Like in this poem. Seeing everyone around you do great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it.
Yeah, I understand.
But the other nice thing about simple writing is that it puts more weight on the wordplay. Like, I set up for a rhyme at the end, but then made it fall flat on purpose. It helps bring out the feeling in the last line.
So you did. And you did, yeah.
I guess more went into it than I realized. That's what it means to be a pro. I'm glad you learned something. Didn't expect that from the youngest one here, did you?
I kind of figured she was younger than everybody there.
Yeah, I guess not. I decided to humor her with that last comment. I don't really care how old everyone is, but if Natsuki is feeling proud, then I won't take that away from her.
At least she kind of knows what she's talking about, though. Like just dropping that with the last line of the poem. That just, like, puts a halt to everything and makes you think. Alright, Yuri.
Yuri stares at the poem. A minute passes, more than enough time for her to finish reading.
Sorry. I forgot to start speaking.
It's fine, don't force yourself.
I'm not. I just need to put my thoughts into words. Hold on. Okay. This is your first time writing a poem, right?
Yeah. Why do you ask?
I'm just making sure. I guess that it might be after reading through it.
So it's that bad.
No! Did I just raise my voice? I'm so sorry.
Yuri buries her face in her hands. couldn't help but notice that it's been several minutes and we really haven't gotten anywhere. It might take Yuri a while to get used to new people. It's fine, I really didn't notice. What were you saying?
Right, it's just that there are specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers. And having been through that myself, I kind of learned to pick up on them. I think the most notable thing I recognize in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberate. In other words, they tend to pick a writing style separate from the topic matter, and they form fit the two together. The end result is that both the style and the expressiveness are weakened. Once Yuri finds her train of thought, it's as if her demeanor totally changes. Her stammering is completely gone, and she sounds like an expert. Of course, that's not something you can be blamed for. There are so many different skills and techniques that go into writing even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take you some time, but it all comes with practice, and learning by example, and trying new things. I also hope that everyone else in the club gives you valuable feedback. Natsuki can be a little bit biased, though.
Biased? How?
Well, never mind. I shouldn't be talking about people like that. Sorry.
It's fine. I'm not sure if Yuri is apologizing to herself, to me, or Natsuki. Do you mind if I read your poem now?
Please do. I'd love to share my thought process behind it.
Yuri smiles dreamily as if it's a rare opportunity for her. I love that she's excited about it, which itself is kind of funny. After all, isn't this supposed to be a literature club? Oh my god, her handwriting is way better than mine. Ghost under the light. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow, bathing. It must be this one, the last remaining streetlight to have withstood the test of time. The last yet to be replaced by the sickening blue-green hue of the future. I bathe, calm, breathing air at the present but living in the past. The light flickers. I flicker back. That's a poem, man. I love that. Something that makes you just, like, relaxed and just think about those words.
I'm sorry if I have such terrible handwriting.
It's better than mine in real life.
What? I didn't think about that at all. But it took you a long time to read.
No, it didn't.
Well, I just don't read script very often. I actually think your handwriting is pretty. Eh? That's a relief.
Also, I liked the poem.
Even though it's short, it was really descriptive. It wasn't too short? I usually write longer poems.
Not at all.
I'm really glad you like it. I'll be honest. Since it's our first time sharing, I wanted to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I suppose.
Are you into ghosts, Yuri?
Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, Genocide.
Really? I must have totally missed the point.
Well, I suppose you did only glance over it, after all. But remember that poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences in their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost. Lingering in her last remaining place of comfort, unable to let go of the past. And soon to be left with nothing.
That's a lot more solemn, putting it that way. I hadn't even thought of that. That's impressive.
It's nothing, really. Well, it makes me happy that you think that. Just remember that it won't be long before you pick up on these things, too.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I guess I'll have to keep trying.
I'm counting on you.
Alright, just Monica left then.
Hi, Genocide.
Having a good time so far?
Yeah. Good. Glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have any suggestions for the club, like new activities or things we can do better, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay?
Alright, I'll keep that in mind.
Of course I'll be afraid to bring things up.
I'm much better off just going with the flow until I'm more settled in. Anyway, want to share your poem with me?
It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to.
Don't worry, Genocide. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know? But it's that sort of barrier that we'll all learn to get past soon.
Yeah, that's true. I hand Monica my poem.
I like this one. It makes me think of something Sayori would like.
Is that so?
You and Sayori are really good friends, right? I wouldn't be surprised if you had these sorts of things in common.
Oh, well, we may be good friends, but Sayori and I are actually really different.
Hmm? Well, that may be the case. But maybe there are also some similarities that you wouldn't expect. The way she talks about you. It sounds like the two of you really care about each other's well-being. Even if you show it in different ways, it ends up being more similar than you'd think. So I think that's the kind of vibe I get when reading your poem.
Hmm? You sure you're not reading into it too much?
I could be. Oh gosh, I sound like Yuri. But in any case, Sayori's writing has kind of a gentle feel to it. I can tell that she likes exploring with emotions, like happiness and sadness. Who knew that someone so happy would enjoy sad things too?
Yeah, that's totally unexpected.
Well, to each their own. And you shouldn't be afraid to experiment a little bit either.
I'm sure I'll end up trying different things a lot. It could take a while before I feel comfortable doing this.
That's okay. I'd love to see you try new things. That's the best way to find the kind of style that suits you. Everyone else might be a little biased towards their own kinds of styles, but I'll always help you find what suits you the most. So don't force yourself to write the way everyone else wants you to write. It's not like you have to worry about impressing them or anything. Anyway, do you want to read my poem now?
Don't worry, I'm not very good.
You sound pretty confident for someone who claims to not be very good.
Well, that's because I have to sound confident. That doesn't mean I always feel that way, you know?
I see. Well, let's read it then.
Hole in wall. Oh, there's a... Okay, it's just a little longer. Hole in wall. It couldn't have been me. See the direction the sparkle protrudes. A noisy neighbor? An angry boyfriend? I'll never know. I wasn't home. I peer inside for a clue. No, I can't see. I reel, blind, like a film left out in the sun. But it's too late. My retinas. Already scorched with a permanent copy of the meaningless image. It's just a little hole. It wasn't too bright. It was too deep, stretching forever into everything. A hole of infinite choices. I realize now that I wasn't looking in. I was looking out. And he on the other side was looking in.
That's really good, I like that.
So, what do you think?
It's very freeform, if that's what you call it.
Sorry, I'm not really the right person to ask for feedback.
It's okay.
Yeah, that kind of style has gotten pretty popular nowadays. That is, a lot of poems have been putting emphasis on the timing between words and lines. When performed out loud, it can be really powerful.
What was the inspiration behind this one?
Well, I'm not sure if I know how to put it. I guess you could say that I had some kind of epiphany recently. It's been influencing my poems a bit.
An epiphany?
Yeah, something like that. I'm kind of nervous to talk about deep stuff like that, because it's kind of coming on strongly. Maybe after everyone is better friends with each other. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes when you're writing a poem, or a story, your brain gets too fixated on a specific point. If you try so hard to make it perfect, then you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on paper and tidy it up later. Another way to think about it is this. If you keep your pen in the same spot for too long, you'll just get a big dark puddle of ink. Well, yes. So just move your hand and go with the flow. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
Okay.
Phew. I guess that's everyone. I glanced around the room. That was a little more stressful than I anticipated. It's as if everyone is judging me for my mediocre writing abilities. Even if they're just being nice, there's no way my poems can stand up to theirs. This is a literature club, after all. I sigh. I guess that's what I ended up getting myself into. Across the room, Sayori and Monica are happily chatting. My eyes land on Yuri and Natsuki. They gingerly exchange sheets of paper, sharing their respective poems. As they read in tandem, I watch each of their expressions change. Natsuki's eyebrows furrow in frustration. Meanwhile, Yuri smiles sadly.
What's with this language?
Huh? Did you say something?
Oh, it's nothing.
Natsuki dismissively returns the poem to the desk with one hand.
I guess you could say it's fancy.
Thanks. Yours is cute.
Cute? Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about the feeling of giving up.
It is. Well, for us, it's giving up, not the animals.
How can that be cute?
I know that. I just meant the language, I guess. I was trying to say something nice.
Huh? You mean you have to try that hard to come up with something nice to say?
Thanks, but it really didn't come out nice at all.
Well, I do have a couple suggestions.
If I was looking for suggestions, I would have asked someone who actually liked it. Which people did, by the way.
Sayori liked it.
And Genocide liked it too.
So based on that, I'll gladly give you some suggestions of my own. First of all,
excuse me, I appreciate the offer, but I've spent a long time establishing my writing style. I don't expect it to change anytime soon, unless of course I come across something particularly inspiring.
Which I haven't yet.
And Genocide liked my poem too, you know.
He even told me he was impressed by it.
Natsuki suddenly stands up. Uh-oh. Why'd the music turn off?
Oh? I didn't realize you were so invested in trying to impress our new member, Yuri.
The goofy music now.
That's not what I... You're just...
Yuri stands up as well.
Maybe you're just jealous that Genocide appreciates my advice more than he appreciated yours.
Huh? How do you know he didn't appreciate my advice more? Are you that full of yourself?
No. If I was full of myself, I would deliberately go out of my way to make everything I do overly cutesy.
Is everyone okay?
Well, you know what? I wasn't the only one whose boobs magically grew a size bigger as soon as Genocide started showing up.
Whoa! Okay.
Natsuki!
Natsuki, that's a little...
This doesn't involve you!
I don't like fighting, guys!
Suddenly both girls turned towards me as if they just noticed I was standing there.
Genocide, she's just trying to make me look bad.
That's not true. She started it. If she could get over herself and learn to appreciate that simple writing is more effective, then this wouldn't have happened in the first place. What's the point in making your poems all convoluted for no reason? The meaning should jump out at the reader, not force them to have to figure it out.
Help me explain that to her, Genocide.
Wait, there's a reason we have so many deep and expressive words in our language. It's the only way to convey complex feelings and meaning the most effectively.
Avoiding them is not only unnecessarily limiting yourself, it's also a waste.
You understand that, right, Genocide?
Well?
How do I get dragged into this in the first place? It's not like I know anything about writing. But whoever I agree with will probably think more highly of me.
Oh god, no, I don't want to pick.
So of course that's going to be- okay, so... Yuri was- when you get down to it, Yuri was just kind of paying her a compliment, but still, you know, it's a critique. It's a critique of our poems. And Natsuki did overreact to it. So... I don't know if Sayori would be any help, so... I'm gonna go with Yuri. Natsuki.
You're right that I liked your poem.
See?
Wait. That's not an excuse for you to be so mean. You shouldn't pick a fight just because someone's opinion is different.
That's right. That's not what happened at all. Yuri wouldn't even take my poem seriously.
I understand. Yuri? You're a seriously talented writer. It's no secret that I was impressed.
Well, that's...
But here's the thing. No matter how simple or refined someone's writing style is, they're still putting feelings into it, and it becomes something really personal. That's why Natsuki felt threatened when you said her poem was cute.
I see. I didn't notice that I'm sorry.
But Natsuki, you took it way too far. Yuri means well, and if you just told her how you felt, then this wouldn't have happened in the first place.
That's true. Are you kidding? That's exactly what I did! It was her that-
Natsuki, I think that's enough. You both said some things that you didn't mean. Yuri apologized. Don't you think you should too? Natsuki clenches her fists. In the end, nobody has taken her side. She's trapped, at this point being defiant only because she can't handle the pressure.
I end up even feeling bad for her.
Sometimes when I'm hurt, it helps to take a walk and clear my head. Sayori, she
doesn't need to.
You know what? I'm gonna do that. It'll spare me from having to look at all your faces right now.
Without warning, Natsuki snatches her own poem up from the desk and storms out. On her way out, she crumples up the poem with her hands and throws it in the trash.
Natsuki.
She really didn't need to do that. I look across the room. Yuri has her chin buried in her hands while she stares down at her desk. I gingerly approach her and sit in an adjacent chair.
Everything alright?
I'm so embarrassed. I can't believe I acted like that. You probably hate me now.
No, Yuri. How could anyone not have gotten frustrated after being treated like that?
You handled it as well as anyone could. I don't think any less of you.
Well, alright. I believe you.
Thanks, Genocide. You're too kind.
Yes, I am.
I'm thankful to have you a part of this club now.
Aw.
It's nothing. One more thing. That one thing that Natsuki said about, you know, I would never do anything so shameful. So,
huh?
What thing did Natsuki say? Well, never mind that. I'm going to go make some tea. It was the boob thing. Good idea. Make enough for more than one person, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, everyone. It's just about time for us to leave. How did you all feel about sharing poems?
It was a lot of fun.
Well, I'd say it was worth it.
It was alright. Well, mostly.
Genocide, how about you?
Well, yeah, I'd say the same.
It was a neat thing to talk about with everyone.
Awesome! In that case, we'll do the same thing tomorrow. And maybe you learned something from your friends, too.
So your poems will turn out even better. I think to myself, I did learn a little more about the kinds of poems everyone likes. With any luck, that means I can at least do a better job impressing those I want to impress. I nod to myself with newfound determination.
Genocide! Ready to walk home?
Sure, let's go. Sayori beams at me. It truly has been a while since Sayori and I have spent this much time together. I can't really say I'm not enjoying it either.